Hey everyone, picture this. You're grinding away on a video edit in CapCut, the render bar's moving slower than a sloth on a coffee break, and your computer's practically begging for mercy. Your CPU's gasping at 90%, your NVIDIA GTX 1650 is chilling at a pathetic 11%, and you're sitting there thinking, why isn't my GPU stepping up? Sound familiar? Well, buckle up, because today, I'm diving deep into this tech nightmare. Why CapCut's snubbing your NVIDIA card, and how we can whip it back into shape. Trust me, by the end of this, you'll have some tricks up your sleeve to fix this mess. So, here's the scoop. You've got a decent rig, an AMD CPU, an integrated AMD Radeon GPU, and a discrete NVIDIA GTX 1650. You're rendering a project in CapCut, and the numbers are grim. The CPU's maxed out, the integrated GPU's pulling a respectable 45%, but your GTX 1650? It's barely clocking in at 11%. You've tweaked the NVIDIA control panel, watched every tutorial YouTube's got, and still, NIDA. Your RAM's at 86% with just 8 GB, and your CPU's sweating at 3.97 GHz. It's a classic case of, why isn't my hardware doing what it's supposed to? I've been there, and honestly, it's maddening. Like buying a sports car and only using it to idle in traffic. Let's get to the bottom of this. Why is CapCut ghosting your NVIDIA GPU? From my experience digging into tech quirks like this, there are a handful of usual suspects. CapCut's a lightweight editor, great for quick cuts and TikTok vibes, but it's not always a champ at tapping into dedicated GPUs like your GTX 1650. It often leans hard on the CPU or defaults to the integrated GPU, especially if the settings aren't dialed in right. Then there's the driver drama. NVIDIA and AMD drivers can sometimes play tug of war, leaving your GTX 1650 sidelined. And don't get me started on Windows. It's got a sneaky habit of picking the integrated GPU for apps unless you force its hand. But here's the kicker. It doesn't have to be this way. I've wrestled with setups like yours before, and there's always a way to nudge things in the right direction. Let's break it down into actionable steps. Stuff you can try right now to get that GPU working harder and give your CPU a breather. First up, let's poke around in CapCut itself. Fire it up, head to the settings, look for a little gear icon or something similar. Hunt for anything labeled hardware acceleration or GPU settings. If you spot an option to pick your GPU, make sure it's locked on the NVIDIA GTX 1650, not auto or system default. I've seen auto screw me over plenty of times, defaulting to the weaker integrated GPU when I least expect it. If CapCut's being stingy and there's no GPU option, that's a clue it might not play nice with your NVIDIA card out of the box, but don't give up yet. Next, let's revisit the NVIDIA control panel. I know you've been here already, but humor me. It's worth a double check. Open it up. Open it up, swing over to Manage 3D Settings, then hit the Program Settings tab. Find CapCut in the list. If it's not there, click Add and track down CapCut.exe in its install folder. Once you've got it, set the preferred graphics processor to High Performance NVIDIA Processor. While you're at it, if you see anything about CUDA or OpenCL, make sure those are pointing to the NVIDIA card too. Hit Apply, restart CapCut, and keep an eye on that GPU usage. Still stuck? Windows might be the culprit. It loves to meddle with GPU priorities. Press Windows I to jump into Settings, then go to System, Display, Graphics Settings. Click Browse, find CapCut.exe, add it, then hit Options and pick High Performance. That's you telling Windows, hey, use the GTX 1650 for this. No excuses. Restart CapCut again and see if that shakes things up. Now let's talk drivers, because they can make or break your setup. Head to NVIDIA's site or pop open GeForce Experience and grab the latest driver for your GTX 1650. Install it clean. Check the Perform a Clean Installation box to wipe out any old junk. If you're already on the latest and it's still a bust, try rolling back to an older version. I've had new drivers tank performance on specific apps before, and CapCut might be picky like that. Also, since you've got AMD and NVIDIA GPUs in the mix, there's a chance their drivers are stepping on each other's toes. If you're up for it, you could uninstall the AMD GPU drivers to test, but that's a last resort. Things can get messy fast. Your RAM's another sore spot. 86% usage on 8 GB is brutal for video editing. CapCut might be choking because it's juggling too much. Close every app you don't need before rendering. Browsers, Discord, all that noise. If you can swing it, upgrading to 16 GB would be a game changer. I made that jump years ago, and it was like giving my system a shot of adrenaline. Suddenly, everything ran smoother, even lightweight stuff like CapCut. Here's a wild card. CapCut might just not be built to lean on your GTX 1650 the way you want. Some editors are finicky about GPU support, especially free ones. If you're fed up, try DaVinci Resolve. It's free, loves NVIDIA GPUs, and honestly, it's blown my mind how well it handles rendering compared to CapCut. I switched to it for a project once when CapCut was lagging, and I never looked back for bigger edits. Filmora's another solid pick, light, user-friendly, and decent with GPU acceleration. Oh, and keep an eye on heat. Your NVIDIA's at 56 degrees Celsius, totally fine, but your CPU's taking a beating at 90%. Download HW Monitor and check its temp. If it's pushing past 90 degrees Celsius, it might be throttling, which could explain some of the sluggishness. A quick fan clean or better cooling could save the day if that's the issue. So, here's your battle plan. Tweak CapCut settings, lock in the NVIDIA GPU in the control panel and windows, update or roll back drivers, free up RAM, and maybe test a new editor. I'd bet good money one of these will get your GTX 1650 flexing its muscles. Maybe not 100%, but a heck of a lot more than 11%. In my opinion, CapCut's dropping the ball here. It's got the potential to use that GPU better, but it's stuck in CPU mode unless you force it otherwise. Rendering shouldn't feel like a punishment. And with a rig like yours, it doesn't have to. Give these fixes a shot. I'm rooting for you to turn this around and get back to creating without the tech headaches.
If you enjoy this video, please like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell to the latest update from my channel. Thank you for watching till the end, and see you in the next video.